What's up, everybody? Once again, it's BrandMan Sean, and today is the first video in my rebranding series, and the first method that we are going over is the pullout method. Now, what is the pullout method exactly? Well, I give you a hint. There are two musicians who have done this so well. Number one is Her. That's capital H-E-R. Her, she's an R&B singer and also Marshmello. He's an electronic music producer. Now, if you don't happen to know either one of these, you will start to know them by the end of this video and why what they did was so great for how they rebranded themselves. Now, what's really interesting about both of these individuals is they have a mysterious brand. Who is Her? Who is Marshmello? Well, I'm about to tell you. Her's real name is Gabby Wilson, but when Her first came out, nobody knew this for a while. You can see Gabby Wilson do an interview on Sway in the Morning 4 years ago, and she is amazing. She plays a lot of different instruments. Her voice is dope. She's just a dope artist altogether. She was out there and moving up that artist ladder. In terms of Marshmello, his real name is Christopher Comstock, and when he was originally rising in the music game, he went by .com for his producer name. Of course, there's music out there and interviews with him as just Christopher Comstock, aka .com, as well. So here's the three things that are important to use the pullout method. Number one, get in the game. And when I'm talking about get in the game, if you notice, once again, both of these people, Gabby Wilson and Christopher Comstock, were already in the game. They were moving up the ladder. They were making a name for themselves. However, it only went up to a certain level. They weren't huge artists, but they had enough energy around them in the industry where they started to at least be known more so by the names behind the scenes, not necessarily having a huge fan base themselves. Number two is absence. This is when the pullout happened. You got out there, you started to move, you started to develop a little bit of an audience. However, you pull out, you're gone. What happens to you for 2 years, 3 years? Both of them were gone for at least 2 years. Gabby was probably about three, maybe even four. Why is this part so important? Because just being absent is one of the easiest ways to rebrand. When you're gone, people kind of forget about you, out of sight, out of mind, especially when you haven't gotten to a certain level in the first place. There's a lot of people who didn't get to know you in the first place. So you don't even have to rebrand to most people. Number three, this is where it gets a little bit tricky, but rollout. The rollout method matters. How you come back out that second time around will be determining your new brand. At being away for a while, once you pull out, you don't really have to worry too much about what people are going to think about you when you come back. You just have to come back. The important thing is how you guide them with your new brand. What is your new brand going to be, and what do you want to be perceived as? This is why using the pullout method is so particular to actually having to get a certain level of rise and notoriety within the industry, even if it's just with the people behind the scenes, is so important. When these people go throughout their rollout method, there's a certain things that they could get done because they already have relationships in the industry. When Gabby came out as Her, she already was signed at RCA. So she had a team behind her and pushing her. She didn't have to develop this brand all by herself and build awareness for it. I did a video, I'll put the link in the description below, of her rollout strategy, just the digital portion of it and how they really started to build an audience and awareness. But a lot of it had to do with the silhouette, but then how they pushed it heavily on social media with dope music on top of that. The dope music has to be a part of it because Her and Marshmello both became music heavy. They built their brands around their music their second time around because they didn't even reveal who they were in terms of their face, and they didn't even do a lot of interaction in terms of personality. So it's not like they were mysterious people who were coming out with comedy skits or anything like that as well. That is an option. Maybe somebody will do it. That would be kind of dope. And what's so great about this is when people originally encountered these mysterious brands that got pushed to a lot of people, it created this buzz, this stronger than usual buzz, because you're getting pushed, you have all this dope music, but everybody's wondering, who is this person? It became a little bit of a game, an Easter egg, as all these fans started to come together and start to research who this person might be. In both situations, if you notice, I know that it's Gabby Wilson and I know that it's Christopher Comstock. These names were revealed eventually, not because they openly just said, hey, I'm this person, but people did their digging, and now they don't necessarily deny it, but it's not really the center of the attention. So even though real fans know at this point, it doesn't matter because they built their brand so strongly around this new mystery and it's around the music more than anything. The fans don't really care too much about the real person in terms of their personality. Their brand isn't built off of that type of foundation like a lot of other artists are. So once again, to summarize the pullout method, if you want to use this method, you have to do a little bit of work, you know, to build up your name. Once again, you don't have to necessarily be famous and even have an original buzz with a lot of fans, but at least getting something going where you have some back-end resources. You're moving without the industry, throughout the industry, and then you pull out the game, you go behind the scenes, maybe you're just writing for people, you're building other relationships. However you do that, when you come back, you have a brand, in their case, a mysterious brand that you allow to build buzz. And you're using all of these resources around you, all of these connections that you built while you were behind the scenes to now push your brand forward, because your rollout matters. When you hit that second time, you want to hit hard. And that's the pullout method. I want to know what you guys think in the comments below. Once again, I put the her rollout method, how they did that on digital, in the description below. Go ahead and check that out. That video is like 2 years old maybe at this point, but it's still true, so maybe it's helpful. Other than that, if you like this video, go ahead and hit that like button. If you like it, you might as well share it. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.